To show you how to register these activity lifecycle callbacks, I created a new project named Lifecycle, and I used the empty activity template. And in here, I've started modifying the main activity file. So I went through and overrode each of the major activity lifecycle methods on create, on start, on resume, on pause, and so on. And here, I'll give you an example of how I did that. Now, on my version of Android Studio, I have a keyboard shortcut to pull up the override method menu. So I have Control O and pulls up this list of methods that I can override. From here, I want to choose on stop. Click OK, and that pulls in the method for me. So Android Studio automatically helped me add the method into my app. Now within each method, I'm going to call the superclass version of the method. This will execute the instructions within the onStop method of the app compat activity. And remember, that's the class that we overrode. So this superclass is the one that does the real work in terms of showing the window on the screen and other behind the scenes stuff that makes the activity work. So whenever you override a lifecycle method, be sure to call the superclass version of that method first. Now after this line, we can add in our own logic. I'm going to add in a line of code that prints out a log message with the name of the method, as well as what activity lifecycle method is hit. So once the app is running on my device, the activity immediately launches, and I can check the logs and see that onCreate, onStart, and the onResume methods have been called. Now when I hit the home button, the activity is no longer visible. So the onPause and the onStop methods should have been called. And here they are in the logs, so we're doing good. Now if I go back into my app, then the onStart and onResume methods get called. And then the activity is now active and I can interact with it. All right, so I know that was a lot of information to take in. And it might be a hard concept to grasp at first, but don't worry. As you see more scenarios of this app and future apps, you'll learn how to better manage the activity lifecycle. And if you'd like to experiment with activity lifecycle methods, I've linked the code that we've looked at here down below.